I'm right here. This is a one
motorboat.
How many legs did you say?
When I'm trying to squeeze you for one page, I start taking out lines in between things. I'm squishing it.
Yeah,
I do
too.
I like one page.
Okay, the next discussion is about possible release of the communications power option.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, I handed out to you a small diagram that shows what I have historically called the Boys Lodge property, which is the property up the hill near the 400 interchange that houses the Forsyth County's Boys Lodge directly adjacent to the juvenile court facility. Back when that piece of property was acquired back in 2004, there was a 0.03 acre parcel of that property that was not conveyed to the county, and it was in fact held in the name of the owner, LaRose P. Manton. But LaRose P. Manton did execute in favor of the county what I am calling a unilateral option agreement. On that 0.03 block, and you can see it highlighted in yellow on the little site plan that I've provided you, there is a communications tower. That communications tower has equipment pursuant to a long-term lease with Sprintcom. It is a communications tower. It's going to have probably cell phone or mobile phone data communications equipment on it. The lease with Sprintcom has an initial term till 2007, and then Sprintcom has five renewal terms that could, if every one of them is triggered, would result in the lease not ending until November 10th of 2022. Everybody with me? So 0.03 piece of property, tower on it, county doesn't own it, but we have a unilateral and irrevocable option to acquire it. We have two bases by which we can acquire this piece of property. Number one, we can wait till the lease with Sprintcom naturally terminates. And at that point, when it naturally terminates, the owner has to put the county on notice of the termination of the lease, and then they have to give us an option to buy it. The purchase is a little convoluted. It makes sense. First of all, we go secure an appraisal. We tender it to the owner of the property. If they don't like it, they go get an appraisal and tender it to us. If we don't like it, then both the county and the owner agree on a third MIA appraiser, and we're stuck with that figure if we want to buy it. All right, that's one option. The other option is, during the pendency of the option, at any time, we can put the property owner on notice that we want to purchase the property. Ostensibly, if it's during the term of the lease, we would buy it subject to the lease, but we could do that as well, and the same sort of appraisal math would still apply. We get an appraisal, they get an appraisal. If we don't agree, we get a third, and that would be the price. So that's our option we have for this 0.03 acre piece of property. Property owner has now come to us, the county, and said they would like to buy us out of our option right. Okay, they would like to buy us out of the option, and they are proposing $25,000 to do that. That would ostensibly have us doing a release of the option, and at which point that 0.03 piece of property would be wholly unencumbered, and would therefore not have an option, and therefore the underlying fee property owner could do with it as they will, obviously subject to the lease, which I suppose the fee is much more valuable without our option attached to it. Makes sense, right? So get rid of our sort of encumbrance, if you will, on their alienability rights. But that's it. There's nothing more to it. That's what we have. We've received a proposal to buy us out of what we have for $25,000. I brought it to the board.
Do we know for a fact that the lease has not expired or terminated for some other reason other than that?
I do not know the answer to that question.
Can we talk to IT? What do we call it?
I will, Commissioner Boff, to your, or Chairman Boff, to your question though, if the lease had expired, there would have been an obligation by the fee owner to put us on notice of that fact to trigger the option. So forgive me. Based upon the lack of that notice, I'm very much assuming the lease has not expired.
I don't wish to vote.
Could we actually use this tower as one of our
you could put a tornado warning.
Tornado warning out if we negotiate.
I don't know whether this is old.
I don't know. I don't know what the structural integrity of it, whether it can handle it.
This is hard to come to reasonable because I don't know the reason why this was done in the first place or the plan behind it or whatnot. My first impression is why do it? Why not just see how much it's worth in 2022? And if it's worth a lot, especially if there's a lease on it, buy it then and have the revenue come into the county.
But we have to get it appraised, man. It could cost about as much as the lease did. So you look at it that way. We got to go through arbitration or have three appraisals.
Well, I mean, this is less than an acre of land. I would imagine for $1,000 you could get an appraisal on it.
Yeah,
but the value of this piece of property is the income stream. That's all there is.
We're not buying a piece of property in 20 years. What if it goes up in a tower? I mean, we're buying an income stream, so we're not going to make money off of it.
Oh, I see. What you're saying is somebody will say, you know, they're making, let's say, $10,000 a month for the next 5 years, then,
yeah.
Therefore it's worth
$5,500. If we have an appraise and we have to go to the
Okay, so I see that point. Then the question is, why is $25,000 now the right number?
Because we need that piece of property. Is any foreseeable
future? No, I think it puts us in competition with our own citizens. I think we talked about that before, that county putting cell towers on county property. We've shied away from that because a lot of our citizens use that as.
And I would normally agree with you, except this was part of a bigger deal. And there had to be thinking because this, what's not here in our books is that this is associated with the selling of the property that the Boys Lodge, I think, is on.
Maybe we ended that because the lease was there.
I think the cell tower was built before the Boys Lodge. It was there before.
No, but what I'm saying is this is all associated with that, and it's very hard to establish.
I think there was a time, Mr. Chairman, that the board did in fact want this. I don't know exactly why. Perhaps we thought there would be a public safety complex up on that hill. That was at one point long ago one of the thoughts behind that piece of property. Perhaps there might be some public safety communication facilities. There was an interest by the board to at least have a go at this tower.
Why don't we make this a percentage of the lease, the ongoing lease? As opposed to just $25,000.
I understand where you're going. I struggle a little bit with, are we just extracting dollars from because we can or because there's true value to the taxpayers? I don't think there's value to the taxpayers.
If they pay it, the taxpayer won't pay it. Right? The more you get for it, the less some taxpayers are going to have to pay for something. I'm not saying buy it. I'm saying make possibly agree to this, but find out what the lease is bringing in and make it a percentage of that lease.
Aren't these leases into 5-year options now? I mean, they can dish out after.
The original term is over. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So they're in the 5-year renewal terms right now.
That would be counting. We can look at it, but you'd have to look at it at yearly terms or something. So, you know, if they don't renew, $25,000 may be a great deal if they don't renew.
Yeah, but we don't know.
I don't know, but
I would. I think that our thought for having an option was for public safety, not for profits.
Yeah. And I don't know the answer.
And then I'm a little speculating, but it makes sense given what I thought was going to go on.
So why don't we need it for public safety?
Because we're not going to go to public safety. I've got something like one or two
Well, I guess
there's no time.
I just wish I had a justification for whatever the amount is, 25K. I don't know whether that's a good deal, a bad deal, a medium deal, or anything else. It's just a deal.
And that was looking to the board if you want to give me some direction, if you want to decline the proposal, if you want to table the proposal, if you want to give me further direction, or if you want to accept the proposal. I don't mean to limit your options, but those are the ones that come to mind.
I'd make a motion that we table it. And I think my motion is failing due to a lack of a second.
I'd like to see it postponed. I'll make a motion to postpone it to our next work session, March 27th. Because any more information we need, maybe we can find out on March 27th.
We have a motion to postpone this to March 27th?
Yes, sir.
And a second? If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. That passes 4-0 with Commissioner Levent being absent. And we are on to the next.
Mr. Chairman, may I ask a question just very quickly? I mean, Commissioner Amos, this is more to you. What additional information could I bring back? I just don't want to get
here. Yeah, I guess if we can find the terms of the lease. That's saying Mr. Bob, Mr. Chairman's notion is what is the lease worth? I mean,
but that would be more of an appraisal. I mean, that would
yeah,
be.
Yeah, but I don't want to do appraisal on it. I mean,
can we go
ask a private citizen what their private lease terms are?
In other words, maybe go and ask what the income stream is off the.
I don't want to know one. And I say that because I don't think it's government's business to pry.
Well, but they made a deal with the government. This would be one thing if it was just a piece of land sitting there that we walked up and said, what's your lease? But that's not the case here.
Well, they're coming to us. I mean, I think it's not. We could certainly, with good faith, go and say, could you tell us what the lease is worth over the next 20 years so at least we have a little more information than we have now? That's not it.
Yeah, I'm going to structure the ask. If they don't want to give it to us, fine.
I'll report that back.
Yes, sir.
That's all I need.
Thank you. How about 5 minutes?
I'll give her back. It's great.